Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Masquerade of the 2013 North American Disc World Convention. We're going to have a great time tonight. I love the Masquerade, I really do. It's one of the few chances I get in a year to stand under a spotlight for 3 hours. The Masquerade has been an important part of Discworld conventions from the very beginning. And a lot of people will tell you things about them. Some people will tell you the Masquerade is a competition. And when you challenge those people, they point out that we have a panel of judges, and we award prizes. And that they are all the monsters are coming back.
Why?
Said Tiffany. There's no one to stop them. What do you do with the rocks? Imp asked Cliff. I bang them together. And what? What do you mean? And then what? What do you do after you've banged them together? I bang them together again. Death of Rats, sporting his new royal blue. Or, as he says in his own words,
tweak!
Ha ha ha!
this is a rather good party at the moment. However, it might go downhill very quickly at midnight. That's when you think he'll be taking his mask off. Chest with an actor inside it, hat on his knees and elbows, who, when Two Flowers Sean Astin came on, would shuffle in and then settle down, like a dog settles down in front of the fire. And then camera, acting, etc., etc., the actors would do their part, would come to the end of the scene, the director would shout, cut, and the luggage would stand up, and all the extras would go, shit! Because we had forgotten that there was a man in there. As far as we were concerned, the luggage was coming for us. Next up, entrance number 8 in the wizard class. Mrs. Whitlow's vacation.
These trees and bushes to find your banana? I am still quite puzzled as to what I am to do with it once I find it. Unless you wish me to tuck it between the pages somehow, that is.
A trick!
You poor dear thing. Such a dreadful cold you have. Here, blow. At least you are back in your correct shape. Ooh, even if it is a wee bit smaller than usual. Ooh. And look, here is a lovely banana growing all by itself for you. Ooh. Let's go see if the gentleman has done with their little prank. I need to see to the laundry and dinner service.
In the apprentice class.
Thank you.
Introducing Perdita X-Dream. Perdita is smart, sarcastic, ambitious, confident, talented, and thin. She also happens to be stuck in the body of Agnes Nitt, who is smart, talented, and leaking magic all over the place. Just remember, it isn't all over till the fat lady sings. Then, in the apprentice class, Stolat Peasant Girl. Please welcome a typical Stolat Peasant Girl. Exciting facts about our postmaster general. Born Moist von Lipwig, hates strawberries and spinach, practices his handshake every day. No photography, please, it's against his religion. Number 18, not in any class, Captain Angua. Recently promoted Captain Angua of the Ankh-Morpork City Watch, is recruiting new members for the Special Auxiliary. Applicants need only answer a few simple general knowledge questions. Perhaps we can do this as audience participation. For example, if it glows, fizzles, and looks like it's going to explode, shoot you, put it in your mouth, hands up. Put it in your house, hands up. Or run away and contact Sergeant Cherry Littlebottom. If you're smart, if you're brave, if you're ready to be thrown in front of the next fire-breathing dragon to menace Ankh-Morpork, the Special Auxiliary wants you. Number 19 in the apprentice class.
Anything I can get you, boys?
Some toasted white bread, please.
You want butter or jam on that toast?
No, ma'am. Dry. Toast? What? Yes, all right, fine. You make that butter toast, please.
Bring me 4 fried chickens and a scumble. You want chicken wings or chicken legs? 4 fried chickens and a scumble.
And some buttered white toast.
You want anything to drink with that?
No, ma'am.
A scum. Be up in a minute. We got two weirdos out there. Look like they're bringing the end of the world or something.
What do they want to eat?
The tall one wants white bread, toasted. Death. And the skinny one wants four whole fried chickens and a scum. And then, of course. Hey, Dad, hey, Famine.
Whoa. Me and Famine. We're putting the band back together.
Bobby Lee, she'll kill me. Man, you gotta understand that this is a lot bigger than any domestic problems you might be experiencing. What the heck are they talking about? Don't get riled, darling. Don't get riled, darling, to me. And you don't want back on the road anymore. You're living with me now, and you're not gonna go apocalypse with your old friends. But darling, this is Death and Famine from the Four Horsemen. Now look, this is my man, and this is my aunt, and you two are gonna walk right out that door without your buttered white toast, without your four fried chickens, and without war. Now you listen to me. I love you, but I'm war, and I'll make the decisions concerning my life. You better think about what you're saying. You better think about the consequences of your actions.
Did I miss something?